What is going on, guys? Jack here, and welcome to episode 52 of our Liverpool FC playthrough here in Football Manager 2016. And today we have a game at Wembley. It's the FA Cup semi-final against Tottenham Hotspur. If you missed last episode, go check it out. As always, it was the Champions League quarterfinals. If you missed it, yeah, go watch it. If you saw it, well, we're going to try and recover here. There's been no game since the last episode. No new injury news to tell you guys about, so we are going to get straight into today's game. Just going to quickly ask my assistant what he thinks the team should be and then consult the team and just see how I think it lines up. And I'm pretty happy, actually, with the team he's picking. It's pretty much the team that I consider to be my strongest 11 at the moment. I'm actually going to play Thiago Maia, I think, over Jordan Henderson. Thiago Maia not played as much football this year as I expected he would. He's an absolutely incredible player for us, still an absolutely kind of world-class defensive midfielder. But you can see only 15 games this year. Henderson's done quite well when he's been called upon to play that kind of midfield position for us. And Maia did have a back strain at one point. And I don't know, he's just not quite been the player I was hoping he was going to be just yet. He's still a very, very good backup defensive midfielder. And I think today we're going to give him a chance to shine. In terms of the rest of the team, pretty happy with the players at our disposal. It's pretty much our standard lineup. Nothing too crazy going on. The only thing worth noting is Moreno isn't going to be playing today. He's still not 100% fit from his injury, so Fred will keep his spot at left back. But with the exception of that and Maia, it's a full strength team. Dybala and Silva, they've not got a ton of goals in recent games by their standards. I feel like we've not had a hat trick in maybe 3 or 4 games, which is unacceptable. Maybe they can turn it around here. Going to be a shorter episode, of course, because it's just this one game, but it's a big game. We've not won the FA Cup yet, I don't think. Of course, we won the Capital One Cup a few years ago. We won the Premier League last year. This year, if we could do the double of the FA Cup and the Premier League, that would be incredible. Worth noting, guys, in the Premier League, we have 4 or 5 games left of the season. I believe we need 1 point from the remaining games, and Chelsea would have to have a 100% record in order for us to slip up. So we're in a pretty good shape to win that there. Anyway, Mbolo going to have to come on. Mario Silva with a minor facial injury. Now, no matter how minor it is, it's probably not worth risking it. So we're going to bring on Mbolo. He is not too shabby or a striker, though. Looking at the stats early on in this game, fairly 50-50. Not a lot of shots. Not a memorable semi-final, I think it's fair to say. Although, Tottenham on the attack here. And I might switch to our wider system sooner rather than later. Tottenham, a team who in this save have caused me some issues in the past. Although we do win the ball there. Coutinho going to pump it up to Dybala. Mbolo is in the middle. If he gets the ball in, which he does, it's going to be a goal. And Mbolo with a fine finish. Dybala, an incredible assist, an unselfish cross. Just whips it in. Bruel Mbolo lurking there. And, well, we see a fair few of those goals. Dybala, the kind of striker who just sucks in defenders around him to try and quell and kind of, I guess, just extinguish any threat that he provides. But there, he crosses it. Mbolo leaps like an absolute giant, heads it, and I think it's Lloris in goal, has absolutely no chance, and that is a great way to continue on with this game. We're not doing too great in terms of stats, although we have had slightly more shots. It's been one of those games where there's not been many chances either way. Not going to switch to our wider system just yet, but we do need to defend here. Christian Eriksen, capable of picking out a pass, picks out Chadli, who shoots from range. It's blocked. Now can we break? We can't. Berardi to Dele Alli. Walker on the overlap. There's options in the middle here for Tottenham. Ball whipped in. Mignolet spills it, and Mignolet, I tell you what, he's made a few mistakes in recent games. Fenerbahce, he made 2. Made 1 there, but we've dealt with it. Now can we attack? No, no we can't. We give away the ball, and okay, that was the end of that highlight, although immediately another highlight here. We have the ball. Dybala chipped through. Can he score? He can, off the post. What a finish that is. A lovely play. I can't say the word. Placed. Placed finish. Coutinho with a little assist. Little dink over. Dybala just touches it down on his thigh. Hits it on that left peg of his, places it in off the post. It squeezes its way and couldn't have put it any closer without it going in. And wow, 2-0, two really good goals, both kind of instrumentally, kind of, I guess, created by Dybala. The first one, the fantastic cross. The second one, a nice finish after a fantastic ball from Coutinho. And we are now 2-0 up at the break. We are bouncing back well following that defeat last episode, the first one in over 30 games. And it looks like we could be revisiting Wembley in a few weeks for the final. Although, we can't get too carried away just yet because there's still time in this game. Tottenham, not a weak side. They've got some good creative players. We've got to be aware of that. But looking at the time here, looking at the stats, we've been on top. Albeit, it's actually been a fairly 50-50 game and we've actually taken a few of the chances that have come our way. I'm going to change the system. We're going to switch, I think, to the 4-2-3-1. It's a system that I think suits our team quite nicely. I'm going to change our inside forwards to support and Gert to attack. I don't want us to be quite as attacking out wide. Instead, I want the kind of wider players in Coutinho and Mbolo just to drop back a little bit when needed, offer us some necessary width defensively, and maybe grab us a goal with this new shape that we have, as Kyle Walker could be off here. He is off. It's a red card. Tottenham, well, they are now committing suicide here. It's now 2-0. They are down a man, and we could punish them further from the set piece. Klein whips it in. Dybala's there. It's 3-0. That is going to be game over. Dybala's 54th goal of the season. And Walker with the red card, and it's immediately led to a chance and immediately left to a goal. You can see they're actually playing with outer centre mid, I do believe, which is a pretty bold strategy, I think it's fair to say. Actually, you can see they're changing their system. It's the way they've done their kickoff, but yeah, they're going to be going pretty direct here. They're down a man, Tottenham. They're 3 goals down. They are going to need to attack away, and well, we do not need to worry anymore. We are on top in this game. We are having some fun. 3-0 at Wembley. Maybe we can inflict further humiliation here. We have a chance. Dybala, Klein out wide. Cross to Coutinho. Lovely play. Klein again. Whips it in. Coutinho. If he buries that, that's an incredible goal with some crazy interplay between Coutinho and Klein. Unfortunately, though, blocked away. Although we do have a set piece cleared away, and that's probably going to be Volland to get it clear, and Klein will mop it up. But that's probably going to be the end of this chance. And with 20 minutes left, we can make a few changes here. We've got Yuri Tillemans, who's a little bit unfit. I'm going to bring on Predrag the Dragon, the Serbian international, for a bit of football. Also going to bring on, I think, Daniel Sturridge. Just give him some football, because he's not had a lot of football of late, has Daniel. And, he's not 100% fit, but here, we'll bring him on. We'll move Dybala back to that advanced playmaker role. Take off Goetze, get some fresh legs on in the midfield. Maybe score a few more would be nice. But really, at this point, it's looking all said and done in this game. We have been on top for pretty much the entire game. There was maybe a little spell at the start of the second half where Tottenham started to get back into it. Changed our system. The red card for Walker really kind of was a death sentence, I guess, for them. It pretty much secured the result our way. And we're on the attack again here. Sturridge, Dragon. Go on, Dragon. Sturridge, Dybala, Coutinho. Can we work the ball around? Fred out wide. Demire, Dragon. I don't know why I call him Dragon. I should just call him Pre-Drag. It doesn't even matter. It's another goal. It's a Coutinho goal. It's another Dybala assist. 2 goals and 2 assists for Paulo Dybala. He has become the key player in this team, the linchpin of our entire squad. And he just creates so much. He scores so much. And he might well be the best £63 million we are going to spend on this save. He has been absolutely incredible for us, instrumental in our play. And this year he's really taken us to a whole nother level. We are dominating domestically in England. Of course, we unfortunately have dropped out of the Champions League. But with performances like this, who can complain? Dybala on a 9.4 average rating. And with only a few minutes left on the clock, we are going to be returning to Wembley for the last episode of the season. It's going to be one to remember, episode 53. As we will probably be going for the double at the top of the table. And 4-0 here. We are into the final, as I mentioned. Great performance. Going to tell the players that I was very pleased with how they played. We've dominated that game from start to finish. Great result there. We go on marching on. And you can see here, Mario Silva out. We can give him some protective equipment on his face. Tillemans wants a new deal. I'll address that in just a second off camera. But yeah, that's going to wrap up this game for us. In terms of the FA Cup and how we're going to end the season, it will be the FA Cup final I see you guys next time for. We are going to be taking on Swansea. So that's going to be an interesting game, to say the least. They knocked out Manchester United. Swansea have had a really good season this year. They're currently 7th. Worth noting, Brentford and Watford also in 5th and 6th. It's been a bit of a weird season, this one. You can see Manchester United and Tottenham both struggling in the table. Granted, Tottenham do have a shed load of games in hand. But it'll be pretty bizarre to see Manchester United finish 9th and miss out on Champions League football for a third season in a row. Anyway, guys, that is going to wrap up everything from me. Hopefully you enjoyed this episode. Hopefully I'll see you guys for the end of season special FA Cup game. And other than that, it is me, Jack, and I'll talk to you guys in a bit. I'm out. And you jerk it out.